Okay, so today we are going to study about correlation and autocorrelation function. We have studied this in chapter 1, correlation and autocorrelation. When two sequences we perform correlation, then when the sequences are of different, both are different, then we say it as cross correlation. So in the cross correlation, there are two different sequences and we perform correlation. So what is correlation? We have already seen that there is a two operations. One is called as a convolution operation and another one is called as a correlation operation. So in the convolution operation, we perform four different steps. Well, the first step is called as a folding, then shifting, then multiplication, and finally addition. These are the four different operations that we perform while doing convolution operation. Now, in case of correlation, the difference between convolution and correlation is that we perform three steps of operation for, we perform three steps of operation for calculating correlation. What are those three steps? The first step is folding. The very first step is, we don't perform folding operation. We don't perform a folding operation in case of correlation. We perform shifting, multiplication, and addition. These are the three different steps that we perform or we followed while calculating the correlation of the sequence. So we will see this kind of operation by using MATLAB now. But remember that we are performing three different operations in case of correlation and we perform four different operations in case of convolution, right? So I'm going to share the screen. Here we are using a MATLAB. So last time I have explained you where we write a program in MATLAB. We write a program in the editor window of the MATLAB, and the program which is going to save that will have an extension .yum, like docs. The Word file, how do you get what is the extension for Word file? It is .doc. In the same manner for MATLAB file, it is being saved with the extension .yum. .m indicates that this is a MATLAB file. This is the MATLAB file. So here we are writing now program for MATLAB. We want to perform the autocorrelation function. So this is very simple. So we will start with the first command is CLC. What is CLC? What it performs? It clears the command window. So whatever we have written in the command window or whatever present in the command window, that is going to be clear. Now this is clear all and close all. This close all, then clear all. These are the commands which is clearing all the data which is present in the workspace. This data is going to be clear. Then clear all and close all. This command performs the closing of the operation. If the figure window is present, is open, then that will be closed because of this close all of syntax. So these are the initial syntax which you are using for the closing of which we are performing for clearing everything which is present here. Now what we are want an input. Two sequences we want. Now if I want it from the command window, if I am going to get it from command window, then I will have to write as x is equal to input x is equal to input. It indicates that we are asking the sequence from command window. The input command, this input command, it indicates that we are asking the sequence from command window. So in the circular bracket, it is going to be input first sequence. Sequence. Okay. So with this, we can get the first sequence from the command window. By semicolon, this will not be displayed. And the second sequence which we are using called as a Y sequence. So this is X sequence. I am considering now second sequence as a Y sequence. And for this sequence also, I want a sequence to be entered by the user. So I am going to, instead of giving direct sequence in the function or in the editor window while writing the program, instead of directly giving the input sequence, here we will be asking the input sequence user to fill it. So when we will run this program, we will understand. So second sequence I am going to take is input bracket, single inverted comma, second sequence, input second sequence. This is my the second sequence which I am going to take going to enter here. Then this two sequences, if the two sequences are different, then we perform cross correlation operation. If the two sequences are similar, then we perform autocorrelation operation. So now I am going to perform the autocorrelation function where I will be writing, we know that we represent autocorrelation function by gamma xy. So here rxy, which is the autocorrelation output. So this autocorrelation between two different sequences, x and y. So x indicates that the first sequence, y is indicating that it is the second sequence. Now we perform the autocorrelation function. So I want, and what is the syntax actually used for autocorrelation function? So this can be, you can search it from help window. If you don't know which syntax I have to use, then you can find out from the help window. So here, if I'm going to see in the documentation, I can get the corresponding syntax. So if I put it here, correlation, correlation. So this, I want a syntax for correlation. So here cross correlation we are performing. So the function fx is representing the function. So I'm going to use a function in order to perform the cross correlation. And that function is xcorr. This is the function which I'm going to use. The syntax are also given. R is equal to xcorr in the bracket x comma y, where x and y both are different sequences. Then here xy returns the cross correlation of two discrete sequences x and y. The cross correlation measures the similarity between x and shifted copies of y as a function of the lag. X and y have different length. The function appends the zero. That is the usual procedure. If they don't have similar length, then we can make it similar length by appending or by connecting the zero at the end. So here we will be using this function r is equal to x c o r r. So we will write down, we'll use this function. Are you able to see this? What I'm writing? Rxy is equal to, what is the function that we are going to use? Is x c o r r of x comma y. This x and y are the capital letters. So I'm writing here x c o r r of x comma y. Then we can, you go here, the semicolon is put, is been given at the end of this so that it will not be displayed. If I don't give semicolon, the sequence will be displayed into the command window. I will show that also. So we will be now, I want to display this sequence. So I can use the command called as a display command, or if you don't put this display command, DISP, in order to display the statement which I have written inside. So display of cross correlation to relation of two sequences. This is what I am writing here. What is going to display in the command window? That is display this inside of bracket, whatever we have written, it is going to be displayed into the command window, right? So this is going to display in the command window, and then we will be displaying or we will write here directly before this so that you can see the sequence immediately after that. I have now this semicolon I have removed from here. Now see, if I am using this command, I am going to evaluate a single command. So evaluate selection. So what it shows that x is equal to input first sequence. So it is this is going to ask me a first sequence. This is going to ask me a first sequence, right? If I don't give, the sequence will not be taken in for the correlation purpose, because we have not given anything. It will show error. Now this is present in the command window. If I am using this command clc, then what will happen? Whatever written in the command window, it is going to be clear. So clc command is specifically used for clearing the contents of the command window. It is specifically used for clearing the contents of command window. So here I have saved this by the name of correlate. Whatever we are writing or whatever name we are giving, it should not be same as that of the function name. Here function name which we have used is xcorr. So I have given input name or name of this file as a correlat. So this is the name which we should not be same as that of the function. Okay, so I'm going to run this program. If I'm going to run this, change the folder where the location of this function is available. Now the command window, or this is asking me a first sequence. So what is my first sequence? Let's say 1, 3, 5, 7, 4, 2. So this is my first sequence. Then if I enter, then it will ask me a second sequence. I have not given here equal to sign, so it doesn't appear here. It doesn't appear here. So I'm going to give the second sequence. Let's say 2, 1, 1, 2. This is my second sequence. Now I'm going to perform the cross correlation. So here the cross correlation, this statement is being displayed, cross correlation of two sequences. Why it is displayed? Because of this display command. What we have written here, DISP, cross correlation of two sequences. So because of this DISP command, this statement which is present inside of this DISP, it is going to be displayed on the command window, right? So this is the output of correlation. This is the output of correlation. So output of correlation is calculated because of this function XCORR. Because of this function, output correlation is calculated. Are you getting this? Now, if I use this command CLC, what will happen? Whatever contents which are present in the command window, all are deleted. All are removed here from the command window. Now, if I'm going to put here equal to sign, equally that will appear into the command window. That will appear into a command window. So whatever we are writing here, it is going to be displayed into the command window. So if I run this, what I'm getting in the command window, the program is asking for first sequence. Now, if I write here first sequence, let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is my 5-point sequence. Then after entering, again, it is this program will ask for the second sequence. If I'm writing 1, 1, 1, 1 and close it, then it is going to give me a output of cross correlation. So cross correlation of two sequences will appear here. The cross correlation of two sequences you will get at this point. Is that clear? Is that clear? Then the next thing that I want to find out is the autocorrelation function. So we will find out, first of all, autocorrelation function from help window. So we'll write here autocorrelation. So autocorrelation function here, I can see that autocorrelation, AutoCORR, is the function which performs the autocorrelation. Or we will see for discrete signal which function is actually applicable. So we will find out here the syntax for autocorrelation. The syntax for autocorrelation. So here are the syntax, different syntax for the autocorrelation function. So this function is the autocorrelation function. So we will try to use this function. Okay. So we will use this function and we will find out autocorrelation. So I will take here again a display command in order to display the autocorrelation of sequence. Autocorrelation of, there are no two sequences, single sequence which is being taken for two times. So this we will write here. So autocorrelation of sequence, and I have shown you what is the function for autocorrelation is autocorr. This is a function which is being used for performing autocorrelation operation. So with this command now we can get the autocorrelation. The MATLAB is user friendly software, so single command also performs the lot many back end operations. So this is the autocorrelation command which performs the autocorrelation between one sequence taken for two times, right? So autocorrelation function is the is the operation which perform which is being performed by the sequence by itself. Means two sequences of same sequences, when we perform the correlation operation on the same sequences, then that is called as a autocorrelation. Okay, so here if I run this, I will have to enter the first sequence. So let us, every time you can give a different sequence, that is the because of that here we have taken the input from command window. If I write here directly input, it will not ask you for the every time for the input. So here I'm going to write 1 2 3 4 5. This is the first sequence, and second sequence I will write here 2 3 4 6. Let us say these are the two sequences now. Okay, here it is the if you find that there is a problem or error that has been occurred, so let us read this error. What is that error? Undefined function or variable x. So here small x is not defined, the capital X is defined, whereas small x is not defined. So that is why this error has occurred. So we will change it here, and it is going to be a capital X. Then we will run it. Okay, I will have to enter the first sequence 1 2 5 8 9 0. Let's say this is my first sequence, and second sequence is, let us say, 2 2 4 4. This is going to be a second sequence, and if I perform this autocorrelation and cross correlation, this is the autocorrelation of the sequence, and this one is the cross correlation of the sequence. So accordingly the output you will get it here, right? So accordingly you will obtain the output of correlation and autocorrelation. We perform correlation when two sequences of different types are present or are given to me. In that case I can perform the cross correlation function, and when the sequence is now correlated with itself, then that kind of correlation is called as a autocorrelation. Okay, so this is the second experiment called as a correlation, cross correlation and autocorrelation. So write down experiment and upload it in the Google form which I have share, I'm going to share now. So write down the program into the, or it is present in the lab manual only, so you can refer that lab manual and write down this. I'm going to give you this program, so I will write here. Okay, I have written here program, then followed by the this is what is required. I have so write down experiment and upload your experiment in the Google link which will be provided to you. So I'm going to share both. Lab manual as well as the program which we have written now.